Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So welcome to yet another live session wherein we are going to have a look quickly at 5 MCQs which are important for your phase 2 exam, right? So please do let me know if you are able to hear me properly, if you are able to see the screens properly. So I can see Dhricha and Manideep has already joined in. So hi Manideep, hi Dhricha. So please do let me know if you are able to see the screens properly, if I am visible to you guys, so that we can quickly have this particular discussion, right? So guys, what we'll be doing is yes, thank you Dhricha, thank you for the cue. Hi Reena, I hope you all are doing great, right? So today what we'll do is we'll just have a very quick session, 5 to 10 minutes, okay? And this session basically we are going to deal with questions regarding some of the important organizations. These may be attached bodies, these may be statutory body, right? So these are very simple, okay? But yet we can see that as per the trend, there are questions that are being asked in your examination, right? So I can see hi Srivas, hi Nikhil Roth, good evening, hi Sri Vishnu Charan. So guys, I just want to tell you that I hope your preparations are really going good, okay? And we are expecting the results in a while, okay? Like maybe we were expecting it today, let's see if it comes today or tomorrow, right? And we'll immediately come out with a strategy for you guys to follow, so do not worry, we'll be there with you at each step that we take, okay? So these are some of the final selections that we have had recently. In 17, we had 11 out of 46. In 2018, we have had 26 out of 46, right? Okay. So friends, these are some of our toppers, and you can also watch their videos to know about their strategies on EduTap's YouTube channel. Okay. So I can see people joining in. Hi Angad, hi Nishtha. So guys, we will immediately go to the questions. Okay. Not much discussion out here. So you can see on your screens the first question. Now, why these questions are being discussed, it might seem very simple to you guys, okay, but trust me, these kind of questions are being asked these days in the papers after we analyzed our phase 1 paper, okay. So what we need to do is we need to make sure that we are answering the simplest of questions as well, okay. Yes, the results are, you know, it is too late. Hi, Juhi. So do not worry. Do not have that much of tension. You keep preparing. When the results are out, we will just make sure we fast track our preparation. Okay. So the first question that you can see on your screens, TriFit comes under which of the following ministry? So I can see most of you have answered one. Okay. So I can see Dhricha, Rajesh Rao. Hi, Rajesh. So I can see Manaswini Verma. Hi, Manaswini. Hi, Nishtha. So all of you are answering one. Okay. Vipul Verma has answered one. Ashish Sharma has answered one. Right. Great. All of you are participating, coming up with your answers. Right. So that's truly commendable. So yes, the correct answer is Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Okay. So this is very, yeah. Okay. Arjun Munda, Tribal Affairs Minister. Bingo. So we can see some extra information being added here. That's great. Okay. So friends, here if you see the full form of TriFed is also important. Hi Hari. Yes, it is one. So the Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India. This is what is the full form of TriFed, okay, and it came into existence in the year 1987, okay, and it comes under the administrative control of Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Government of India, okay. Its head office is located in New Delhi, and there are also regional offices located at various places in the country, okay. So you should be aware, very simple, but please do spend 1 minute and memorize this, right? Okay, the second particular question that you can see on your screens, friends. So which one of the following is not one of the objectives of TriFed? Okay, so just now we saw that TriFed comes under the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Okay, now you need to tell me which is not an objective of TriFed. Okay, socio-economic development of tribal people, empower tribal people with knowledge, tools and pool of information, capacity building of the tribal people through formation of self-help groups, okay, imparting training to the tribal people for a particular activity, or none of the above. Okay, so you need to tell me the answer quickly. Okay, so Srivas is hoping that the results should come while you're teaching live. Great, no problem, we will continue with the strategy like that. Okay, so Suraj Bhushan says it's 5, none of the above. Okay, Sare says it's 2. Okay, fine. Sun Gwait, okay, this nice name, says 5, none of the above. Reena Thakur, none of the above. Hari Krishna says it is none of the above. Sri Vishnu Charan also goes with the same. Okay, Satish Surela, none. Okay, let's see. Nishtha, okay. Nishtha says five. Nan, Shri Vas, none. Okay. Manaswini Verma, none. Siddharth Patel, hi there, says none. Okay. Rajesh Rao says, okay. Mr. Rahul, okay, hi. So, all of you are going with none of the above. Manideep Vundru says it is three. Capacity building of the tribal people through formation of self-help groups. Okay. So, let's quickly go to the answer now. So friends, the answer for this particular question is none of the above. That means all of the four options above are actually the objectives of TriFed. Okay, so socio-economic development of tribal people, empowering the tribal people with the knowledge, tools and pool of information required. Okay, capacity building of the tribal people through formation of self-help groups. This is also important, friends, and wantedly I have included this word self-help groups because sometimes in the paper they are insisting upon these kind of areas, okay, where SHGs are involved. Okay, so that's the reason it was there. Imparting training to the tribal people for a particular activity, okay, and none of the above. Okay, fine, you understood the four points are objectives of TriFed. So here you can see this is directly taken from the website of TriFed itself. Okay, friends. So ultimate objective is what? Socio-economic development of tribal people. So friends, I think there was a question in your phase one exam that read TriFed is for, I guess, right? That was there. So you need to know under which ministry it is coming and what is the purpose of it. Okay. So these all pointers are important. So keep these things in mind. So Nikhil, no problem. You have retracted your answer. Okay. Vaishali Thakre, hi, you have just joined in. See, we are expecting results by today evening or max by tomorrow. Okay, so let's see, hoping fingers crossed. Okay, guys, fine. So the third question, friends, now NSIC works for what? Okay, you can see the question on your screens and I want the answers from you guys. Okay, is it growth of the rural artisans? Is it growth of micro, small and medium enterprises in the country? Is it growth of the tribal sections of the society? Okay, is it promotion of entrepreneurship among rural women or is it promotion of entrepreneurship among rural youth? Okay, so these are the five options. Now you need to tell me NSIC works for what? Okay, so I can see Lavish Kumar Singh says two. Okay, so growth of micro, small and medium enterprises. Okay, Satish Surela says rural artisan. Okay, let's see other people. Reena Thakur goes with two, MSMEs. Okay, Vipul Verma goes with two. Okay, what about others, guys? Sri Vishnu Charan goes with two, San Goite goes with two, Nishtha Rathi says tribal sections. Okay, fair enough. Hari Krishna says two, fine. What about others, guys? Shubham Shukla says five, promotion of entrepreneurship among rural youth. Okay, Sarman Singh says one. Okay, Sare says tricky one. See, that's what I told. It might seem simple on the outer side, but if when you start thinking about it, it is tricky. Mr. Rahul says MSME. Ratan Kumar says two. Okay, MSME. Shubham Shukla says entrepreneurship among rural youth. Okay, Shrivas says two. Okay, Sunil Meshram says two, Rajesh Rao says 2, Juhi says 5, okay, fine, no idea, fine, fine, Siddharth 2, Sandeep, Suraj, okay, Shrivas 4, oh my god, all of you are juggling between the options, okay, so guys, Sion Biswas says 2, okay, see, what happens here is, now if you just have a look at this question, at the first time, you'll see, okay, they're just asking NSIC works for what, but when you go to the options, this is how they're playing the tricks in the examination. The phase 1 paper specifically, if you refer to, you will realize that there have been simple questions that have been asked, okay, but the options are tricky, okay, and it takes a while for you to hit the right answer, right, friends? Okay, now the answer for this is what? The second option, that is growth of micro, small and medium enterprises in the country, right? So let me tell you, NSIC is National Small Industries Corporation Limited, NSIC, okay, it comes under the Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, okay, and you can see that it is a ISO 9001-2008 certified, okay, so this is important, okay, the standards, and you can see the basic vision of it is to be premier organization fostering the growth of micro, small and medium enterprises in the country. Okay, so that's very simple, fair enough, guys. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Okay, So here, okay, let me just tell you about its functions as well, okay. So here there's a list of functions that is given. Maybe at the later point of time you can go through them, okay. Like if you see, it is also implementing partner for a number of schemes that the Ministry of MSME runs, okay. And it also includes like marketing assistance, bank credit facilitation, performance credit ratings, raw material assistance. So very simple, just have a look at it once, okay. Fine. The fourth question, friends, that you can see on your screens, an important source of livelihood for the tribal people in India is the minor forest produce. Which one of the following is not one of the products under minor forest produce? Okay. So we hear a lot about MFP, okay, and how it is closely related to the livelihood of the tribal people, because a good percentage of their income is through minor forest produce. Okay. So now you need to tell me which is the correct answer for it. Is it timber? Is it bamboo? Is it leaves? Okay. Is it gums or is it nuts? Okay. So I want the answer. So Lavish Kumar says nuts. Okay. Ujwal Dixit says nuts. Satish Surela says nuts. Reena Thakur says nuts. Guys, read the question again. Hare Krishna says nuts. Okay. Siddharth Patel says nuts. Juhi says timber. Okay. Nishtha Rathi says nuts. Sarman Singh says nuts. Read the question again, guys. See, it is very simple, but I can see most of you are going wrong. Let me tell you, nuts is not the answer. Okay. Nuts is not the answer. Try again. Rajesh Rao says bamboo. Okay. Manideep Bundru says it's nuts. Okay. So guys, that's what, you know, whenever we try to take simple things like that, it happens, okay. Nikhil Bahrain says 5, Ratan Kumar, bamboo, okay. Shubham Shukla says leaves. Keto Operator says 1, timber, okay. Sun Goet says it is bamboo. Suraj Bhushan says it is bamboo. So guys, Sare says gums. I can see how confused you guys are, okay. So no problem, it's okay. We are just having a learning thing here, okay. So after this, none of you would get it wrong in the paper, okay. Lavish says timber. Mega Sony says gums. Sunil Mishram nuts, okay. Rahul Timber, self starter, hi self starter, joined in late today, so says gums, okay. Sunil Mishram again 5. Nishtha Rathi says gums, okay. So great, I can see most of you are coming out with a trial, okay. Ma'am, timber is major forest product, okay. So if it is a major forest product, yeah, so you need to tell me the answer then, right? Okay, so great. Okay, fine. So now I think you guys are going to pour out your answers continuously. I'm going for the answer now. Mukul Eka says 3. Okay, let's see. Leaves. Okay. So guys, the answer is timber. Okay, we are talking about minor forest produce, which is a non-wood product. Okay, so let me tell you, or let me show you this. So basically, tribal people are dependent upon non-wood forest produce, which are generally termed as MFPs, minor forest produced. Okay, which means all non-wood timber forest produce which has a plant origin. Okay, so it should have a plant origin and it should be non-timber forest produce. Okay, so here you can say, okay, great. So I'm getting tricky day by day. That's good. Okay, I think fine. So here you can see the options. What are the thing? It will include bamboo. Okay, it will include canes, fodder, leaves, gums, waxes, dyes, resins, and many forms of food also, which includes nuts, wild fruits, honey, lac, tusar, etc. Now, all these have plant origin. See the commonality between all these products. They are of plant origin, right? Okay. Okay, so, and yes, Reena, okay, you are forestry, okay, you have done graduation in forestry. Obviously, your teachers are going to kill you now. Okay, fine, no problem. So, and the next thing is, it is non-timber forest produce. Always keep that in mind. Shubham Singh is asking, when will the result be out? Shubham, do not worry. We were expecting it to be out today. Maybe let's wait for the evening. There is still time, okay. And let's see if it also, there's a chance tomorrow probably, okay. So do not worry, hold on to your horses, okay. So here you can see that they have given another important information, okay, that, you know, minor forest produce starts with the word minor, but it is a major source of livelihood for tribals who belong to the poorest of the poor section of the society. Now see here, MFP has significant economic and social value for the forest dwellers, as an estimated 100 million people derive their source of livelihood from the collection and marketing of MFP. This 100 million figure is based on the report of the National Committee on Forest Rights Act 2011. You never know, this can be extracted and asked. Okay, so just keep in mind, roughly 100 million people are dependent on MFPs. Okay, so that's very, very important. Okay, friends. Okay. Let us move to the last question. Okay, though we have only 5 questions today, but I guess they were tricky ones. I can see you were not able to answer questions. Okay, now this is fairly simple. Okay, so the 5th question that you're seeing on your screens, friends, it says India is the largest coir producer in the world, okay, accounting for more than 80% of the total world population of coir fiber. Sorry, world production. I'm really sorry. World production of coir fiber. We have a special board known as the coir board, a statutory body which works for the development of the coir industry. Okay. Now, the board comes under which of the following ministries? Okay. So, I can see Lavish has answered MSME. Okay. Self-starter MSME. Reena Thakur MSME. Have I framed an easy one this time, or you are not getting it right again? Okay. Nikhil Bhairani says MSME. Ratan, okay, Nishtha MSME, Siddharth Patel MSME, Suraj Bhushan MSME, okay, guys, Shri Vishnu Charan also says MSME, okay, is it the same? Are you all going to give me the same answer? Headquartered in Kochi, okay, so extra information coming out. Dinesh says agriculture and farmers welfare, okay, Sarman Singh says 2, okay, MSME, I can see, Satish Surela also, and Prashanta says, okay, MSME, Sun Guite, okay, Sare says it is Ministry of Agriculture, Hari Krishna says 2, Ministry of MSME, Kitu Operator, I like this name very much, Kitu Operator, nice, so says Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Manideep Vundru says 2, MSME, okay, heard somewhere, no problem, self-starter, Rajesh Rao says 2, Ministry of MSME, it's a tough question, Manideep, seriously, okay, fine, so then thank you so much, I have prepared it well, I've done my homework well then, okay, so Rahul Kumar Singh says MSME, Juhi says Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, okay, thank you, Manideep. Okay, so I can see Shubham Shukla going for agriculture and farmers welfare. Dinesh, MSME. Okay. Yes, so that's the point, you know, the questions should be easy, yet they should be tricky. And that's what NABARD has been doing. If you carefully look at the phase one examination, okay, so they do these things. The questions are fairly simple, but you know, when you go to the options, you're like, okay, what is the correct option, right? Okay, Shashank, great. Okay, so Kitu Operator, I've got your name now, Shashank. Okay, so I hope I remember it in the next session. Great, okay. So guys, the answer for it is Ministry of MSME. Okay, so you all were right, except few. Now, they would also be right after having a look at this particular answer. Okay. Okay, so Shri Vishnu, I have taken this into account that we shall be uploading the PDFs after 34th lecture, and apologies for not doing so for the remaining ones, right? Okay, so guys, here you can see Coir Board is a statutory body. Okay, it is established under the Coir Industry Act 1953. Okay, for promoting the overall development of the coir industry and improvement of the living conditions of the workers engaged in this traditional industry. Now, for those of you who are a little skeptical about what is coir, you can say it's a coconut fiber, natural fiber, which is extracted from the husk of coconut. Okay, so self starter has also given her name. So she's Jayashri. So we have Jayashri in the house, and Kitu Operators is Shashank. So two hidden names are out today. So that's a fairly good thing that I've done today. I've known two names. Okay. So guys, yes, we are done with it here. Okay. And here you can see that we have courses for NABARD 2019. We are running a current affairs and mock test course. Okay. So you can get current affairs and mock test in a comprehensive manner. And there's a 50% off. You can use the coupon code NABARD50. Okay. Mugasil question, which was in phase one. Satish Surela, okay, yes, there was a question on Muga Silk, Assam was the answer. Okay, so the other courses for NABARD is, okay, was it Jharkhand? Let's see, let me clarify and come back to you. As far as I know, okay, fine, Satish, I will come back to this answer, okay, and I'll make sure I correct it if it is wrong in case, okay. So this is these are the other courses, friends. Okay, NABARD Grade A full video course, this ARD course separately, Grade A plus B course is also there, Grade B paper 3 is also there. Okay, so in case of any queries, guys, you know where to call. You can call 814-620-7241. Give us a call, and you can also write us a mail, hello@edutab.co.in, and you can visit our website www.edutab.co.in in case you want to have a look at the course features. Okay, fine. So Assam is correct. Fine. Okay, guys, so anything else you want me to address? I will be closing the session in 1 or 2 minutes. So I can see Shashank is asking me when RBI Grade B notification is coming. We are expecting it to come in July, Shashank. Let's see. Okay, Siddharth, the same thing to you. We are expecting that. We will, as soon as the notification is out, we'll definitely come out with a series or something that's going to help you out, guys. Okay, so yeah, after 15 July. Okay, Reena, let's see. Okay, mid-July. Okay, fine. So we already have experts there in our panel, so we can see Jayashri and Reena answering the queries. So thank you so much. Okay, so Prashanta, welcome. You're welcome, guys. So thank you so much for joining, and hope to see you guys again tomorrow, right, with a couple of questions more, right? So anything else? Okay, Manideep says we request for sessions on fisheries and animal husbandry. Manideep, if you can have a look at all the lectures that are there on fisheries on EduTab's YouTube channel, we have completed fisheries there. Animal husbandry, let me have a look at it. Okay, so Siddharth Patel, you're welcome. Okay, welcome Manideep. Okay, have a great time, you too, Reena. Same here. Okay, so guys, yes, I need to close the session now, and really thank you for joining in. Yes, obviously, Jayashree, my memory is really sharp. So now onwards, Jayashree and Shashank, I'm not going to forget your names, okay? So you're welcome. And please do join in for the upcoming sessions as well. Okay, guys, thank you so much. And as usual, keep smiling and happy learning, right?